Hello, welcome to the detailed walkthrough of Compose. Compose by Communicate is a no-code chatbot builder with powerful NLP. In this video, you will learn how to create a Compose bot, adding and customizing the welcome message, adding intents, small talks, and default fallback, features of webhook, inline code, custom entity, import and export options of Communicate, self-learning feature, the all-new flow designer, and creating a flow in that. Creating a help center bot. Trust me, guys, the features don't end here. We have more amazing features at Communicate. If you want to learn a specific part of this video, please feel free to refer to the timestamps in the description. If you don't have a Communicate account yet, sign up for free through the link given in the description and get hands-on experience with our superbot. If you would like to have a customized demo about our integrations, generative AI-powered chatbot, or any other use case, book a demo for free using the link given in the description. Some of the new generative AI features, such as training your bots on your documents and training your bot with any URLs, are added to our bot now. To access those videos, please refer to the link in the description. Now let's start creating a bot. Once you log in, you will land on the dashboard. Go to Bot Integrations tab. Here you will find the list of bots that are already created. You have to click on Create a Bot in order to create a new one. Click on Compose. You will find many pre-built templates to start with, such as customer support, booking a meeting, restaurants, etc. These templates will have some intents pre-configured. We will use the blank template to create a bot from scratch for this tutorial. Once you select a template, you can name the bot. I am going to give it as Compose Tutorial. Next, choose an avatar of your choice. You can also upload an avatar of your choice. Select the default language and click on Save and proceed to finish the bot profile. For the next part, you can either enable or disable this feature. This feature comes in handy when your bot can't reply to the query asked by the user. Don't worry, even if you disable it now, you can enable it later. You also have the option to let this bot handle all the conversations in the future. Or you can click on I'll set it up later. Now you have landed on the bot builder page. This is the default welcome intent. This is the message that you want the bot to tell the user as soon as they land on your page. Let's give it as, "Hi, hope you are doing fine." You have options here to add more text, buttons, and more. Under More, you can even add an image, choose to hand over the conversation to human agents, or do a custom payload. For example, if you want to ask or say something after "Hi," you can add another text like this, "Please choose the pizza base." Now let's add options for the base. For this, we have to add interactive buttons. Simply click on this button and name it. I am giving it as thin crust. We will have to set an intent for this, which we can do later. Similarly, let's add another button named hand tossed. Here, if you are clicking on the plus mark below, it will appear as a button on the next line as a separate message. If you want to have the buttons in the same message, click on the plus mark next to it. Once created, you can see the preview here. Suppose you need to create another welcome message, click on the add button here. Give this intent a name. Here I will give welcome message type 2 for reference. If you want to specifically customize welcome messages for certain paths or URLs, you can specify it here. Say on the product page, you want a different welcome message, you can add your product page path here and define the intent. I have added the product path name and defined the welcome message as "Hi, welcome here, you have landed on the product page." This means that whenever the user is landing on the product page, they will get this welcome message and not the default welcome message. Likewise, you can configure different welcome messages for different pages. Click on the Save button. Since we have configured the welcome message, now let's test that. Click on this button to test your bot. The welcome message is now displayed. Now let's define the intent for these two buttons. I will name the intent the same as the button name for reference. Here, as you see, in the user's message, buttons will be prompted as soon as you spell it. Select the button and configure the bot to reply to that. We will add a simple thanks for choosing message to both buttons. Now let's test the bot again. There you go, now you get the reply from the bot that we configured and saved. You might be wondering what happens if we type something that is not configured yet. So let's type cheese burst. As expected, the bot says that it doesn't understand. Now you would have guessed what needs to be done. All we need to do is go back, create an intent for cheese burst, and done. Now let's check again. The bot replies now as per the new intent created for the words cheese burst. We will move on to the next segment. Webhooks. For better understanding, I will write a prompt for the user. I will create a new intent under the answers column and name it webhook tutorial for your reference. Here you are going to fetch webhook from elsewhere so you can delete this bot message here. Toggle on the dynamic message in order to set up a webhook. If you have a webhook, you can enter it here or you can create one. For this tutorial, I am creating a new webhook so that you can understand it from scratch. Bceptor is a no-code solution for building and hosting a mock server. I am creating a webhook using this Bceptor and naming it Compose Tutorial in short. Now that you have created one, let's just add a rule to it. Only the post method is needed, so click on the edit button and you can enter your code here. For this tutorial, I am copying a rich message code from our docs page of Communicate. Place your rich message code inside this bracket. The docs page link is also given in the description. Now let's copy this URL and paste it into the Communicate webhook setup. Click on Create and then Train Your Bot. We set up a trigger with the word webhook. Let's test that. Here we go. The webhook is fetched and the reply is sent from that. As you can see, this is the text which we configured in the webhook. Let's repeat the same to test the inline code option as well. Let's add a text in the welcome message for the tutorial's reference. Now I want to give you a gist of how NLP works. If you remember, we configured webhook for the word webhook only. But even if we type it in capital letters or type it in the form of a sentence, the chatbot still understands and replies from the webhook that we set up. This is how NLP works. So previously, the users had to use webhook, create a server endpoint at their side, and write code in that endpoint, which is time-consuming and also requires deployment at their end. Now, there is no need to create a webhook or API endpoint. Customers can directly write code within the Compose interface and go live with bot backend integration faster. That's where the inline code comes in. I am creating an intent named inline tutorial, switching dynamic messaging on, and selecting the inline code. With inline code, you no more need a server to host your code. You can directly write your codes here, and we will host a deployment from our end. Let's create one. You can see the commented lines of codes here. Here you can type your own set of code and deploy it. For this tutorial, let's just uncomment that and deploy the inline code. The inline code is deployed. If you ever wonder what will happen if you don't click on the train bot after defining an intent, let me show you. The bot still won't be trained. See? Just like I told you, the bot is yet to learn about the inline intent. So this is why it's important to click on train bot whenever you create or update a rule. Now let's click on the train bot and see the magic. Ta-da! Here you go. The inline text is given as a reply, which was inside the inline code that we deployed for testing. The next segment we have is small talk. This is the normal chit-chat session that you can do with the bot. For example, if you ask how are you doing, what the bot should reply, and so on. The fourth segment is default fallback. If the bot is unable to answer the user query, the default fallback message gets triggered. I am going to show you how to transfer the conversation to a human agent. You can do this anywhere with any intent. So say, the bot does not understand the user, the message will go out as, "Sorry, I can't understand, I am transferring the chat to a human agent." For now, the bot says, "Sorry, I don't understand to unknown queries." Now I will show you how to configure a default fallback. It's pretty simple. Click on this More button and select Handover option. You will have options to transfer it to a human, a specific human, a teammate, or another bot. I will select a specific human and assign it to myself. Click on Save and test the bot. There you can see, now it has triggered the default fallback and it also got assigned to me. Now the person who got assigned, in this case, me, will get the conversations in the Assigned tab. Here the human agent can talk with the user, address the query, and then resolve it. In your dashboard, you have a tab named Self-Learning AI. As in when the human resolves a query, there you can add phrases to the bot. So the bot will learn the query answered by the human and will attempt to resolve that query without transferring the conversation next time. Now let's go back to our bot and let me tell you more features. It just gets going, right? Our bot is multilingual, just if you don't know. You can select any other language here and all the intents that you have created will be replicated to that language as well, just with a click. Here, for now, you have to replace the messages in the language you want. You can use any translator to do the same. Moving on to the next, the flow designer. Let's create a flow here only to understand it better. Hover around to see the plus or add sign. On clicking it, you can either add a user flow or create a new one. We will configure a simple user flow now to test how it works. I am creating a user message where if the user says flow designer, the bot has to reply something. You also get an option to copy the current intent to other languages that you had opted for. Now that we have configured the user message, let's configure the bot to reply to it. We will add a simple message, "This is created using Flow Designer," and save it. Now you can test the bot here itself. Let's type the user message, "Flow Designer," and wait for the bot's reply. As you can see, the bot replies to the message that we configured. This is how you can create user flows using Flow Designer. Going back to the dashboard, I am adding one more line in the welcome message, asking for the user's name and saving it. Now, as you know, we have to create a new intent for the name message. Let's enter some names here for training the bot. Make sure you enter as many as user messages possible to train the bot correctly. I will explain about another feature called custom entities here. Say if we need to extract any data that the user had entered, we can retrieve it. You can also create your own custom entity. You just have to enter the name and values. We have some default entities here. The name is already configured. You can just copy this entity name and paste it into the bot message. We will add more user messages. Now let's save and test the bot. The bot asks for the name and let's enter Jenny. Here, as you can see, the bot replies, "Nice to meet you, Jenny." It has taken the name from the user and greeted them, telling them their name. This is how entities work. You can type it in a whole sentence also and still the bot would understand. This is why it's a nice practice to give many user messages to train the bot. Let's ask the bot, how to make a pizza. Obviously, as expected, the bot replies that it can't understand. This is where our next feature comes in. Go to the bot builder and click on Settings. Here, you have the option to integrate your bot with ChatGPT. Just a toggle will do. How cool is that? Let's toggle this on and ask the same question again. There you go. The bot, after being connected with ChatGPT, is now able to reply to a query even if it is not configured by the user. Going back to the settings, you can also create entities from this window. Same way, you can create webhooks and inline code from here as well. You also have the option to export and import your intents. You don't have to create all the intents for other bots again, you can just export it and then import that file to your new bot. When you click export, a JSON file will be downloaded which you can later import to use it in another bot. The last section of this tutorial is the Help Center. Here you can create any categories. Say you have different categories, you can create one for each and then create articles under that category. Let's create a simple FAQ category. Let's click on the New Category button. A pop-up will appear where you can enter the category name and its description. I am giving the name as FAQ and a description related to it. Click on Create a Category to create it. Now the category with its name and description is created. Now to create questions or articles under this category, please click on it. Let's add our first question under the FAQ category. We will just add some simple questions and answers for testing out and learning this feature. Can we create a chatbot with no code? And the answer goes as, yes you can, Communicate is here to help you. Make sure you make the article published to make it live. We will add one more article and publish it. Now you can see that two articles are under this category. To customize your Help Center page, go to Customization, which is shown here. You have the default text here which you can change. You can change the colors also to adapt to your brand standards. You have the option to upload your branding here, which could logo or anything that you want to use. You can also enable or disable the Communicate branding. If you want to preview the changes that you have made, you can click on the Preview button here and see how your page would look like. People can also use the search bar to find the questions. Click on Save Changes to make it live. The third option is the Answer Bot. You can connect all these categories to your desired bot. Adding articles to Help Center is the first step that we have done. Step 2 is connecting the bot to it in the settings. Let's do that. We will go to our bot and then the settings. Here, just toggle this button to connect your bot with the Help Center. The final step is to assign conversations to the bot. For that, go to the dashboard settings, click on Conversations, then Rules. Enable this to assign new conversations to a bot and then choose the bot. I will assign it to the bot we used for this tutorial. Now that we have connected our bot to the Help Center, let's test it out once. To give you a better understanding, I will have the articles opened as well. You don't even have to use the full questions exactly, as the bot by itself will learn using the NLP feature. Let's just type Compose. Tada! Here the bot retrieves the message that we have configured in the Help Center. That's a lot of features, isn't it? But we are not stopping here. We will come back again with more interesting features. For the new features, check out the description for the latest videos. If you have not yet used Communicate's chatbot, sign up for free using the link given in the description, and feel free to drop comments if you have any questions. Thanks for watching the video. Subscribe to us and stay updated.